Welcome back to English class. Hello children, hope you all are fine. So today I'm going to start our last chapter from book number 4 and it is from your second assessment syllabus. So children, the name of the chapter is The Unhappy Dragon and it is a very beautiful story about a little dragon named Ali who cannot breathe fire. So children, without wasting our time, let's move to the chapter. Children, now all of you take out your book number 4 and page number 2. Now children, in page number 2, you can see chapter number 7 and the name of the chapter is The Unhappy Dragon. Now children, all of you take out page number 3. Now I'm going to read the chapter and side by side, I will explain the chapter. So all of you, look at your book. Read on to find out what Ali the dragon did to change himself. So now we will read the chapter and we will come to know what Ali the dragon did to himself change. Okay, let's start. A long time ago in a jungle far away, there lived a dragon called Ali. Ali had many friends, good friends like Rob the rabbit, Toro the tiger and Paro the sparrow, and bad friends like Mara the bear and Appu the wolf. Ali was unhappy because of Mara and Appu. They were always making fun of Ali because Ali did not know how to breathe fire. One day, Toro and Paro told him about a kind witch. Her name was Wimpy, and she lived in a nearby village. They said she will be able to help him. So children, once upon a time, far away in a jungle, there lived a dragon called Ali. And Ali had many friends. Some are good and some are bad. So kids, Ali's good friends are Rob the rabbit, Toro the tiger, and Paro the sparrow. And the bad friends are Mara the bear and Appu the wolf. Ali was unhappy because of his bad friends, Mara and Appu. They were always making fun of Ali because Ali did not know that how to take out fire from his mouth. One day, Ali's good friend Toro and Paro told Ali about a kind witch, that is a woman who practiced magic, and her name was Wimpy. Wimpy lived in a nearby village. Toro and Paro said Ali that Wimpy will be able to help him. Now all of you turn the next page, page number 4. The very next day, Ali went looking for Wimpy the witch. He soon reached her cottage and knocked on her door. The witch opened the door and smiled at him kindly. So children, in the next day, Ali went looking for Wimpy. And very soon, Ali reached Wimpy's cottage and knocked on her door. After that, Wimpy opened the door and smiled at Ali kindly. Now kids, turn the next page, page number 5. Ali sadly told her the story. Wimpy promised to make a magic potion for him. It was going to help Ali breathe fire. She started making the potion. Very soon, the potion was ready. Wimpy gave the potion to Ali and he drank it. Then Ali opened his mouth and breathed out. Oh no! Do you know what came out of his mouth? Frogs, Ali was sad. Wimpy asked him to give her one more chance. So children, what happened? Ali told Wimpy the story sadly. After listening, Wimpy promised Ali that she will make a magic potion for Ali, and it was going to help Ali to take out fire from his mouth. Wimpy started making the potion, and very soon the potion was ready. Then Wimpy gave the potion to Ali, and Ali drank it. After that, when Ali opened his mouth and breathed out, instead of fire, frogs came out of his mouth. Again Ali became upset, and Wimpy asked Ali to give her one more chance. Wimpy took out her book of spells and started making another potion. After it was ready, Ali drank it. But this time, books started coming out of his mouth. Books for everybody. Lots of books for Ali to open a library. Now, everybody could read and be happy. Ali was happy too. So Ali thanked Wimpy and went back home to open a small library in his jungle. So children, Wimpy took out her book of magic words and started making another potion for Ali. After that, the potion was ready and Ali drank it. But this time, instead of fire, books started coming out of his mouth. For a few minutes, Ali became very sad. Then Ali think and decided that he could open a library for everybody because he have lots of books and everybody could read and be happy, and Ali too was very happy. Then Ali thanked Wimpy and went back to home to open a small library in his jungle. So children, now we have completed our chapter, The Unhappy Dragon. So I hope all of you have understood the chapter and enjoyed too. So this much for today. Thank you. Goodbye. Take care.